On the night of November 17th of 2022, a swarm of earthquakes began at a volcano within Alaska which has not erupted for several hundred years. These earthquakes occurred at far higher than normal levels and at shallow depths, largely between 2 and 4 miles below sea level. Since this could indicate magmatic activity, the alert level of the Takawangha volcano was raised from green to yellow on November 18th. I want to note that a similar earthquake swarm occurred at Takawangha in January of 2017, which also resulted in a raised alert level, but did not result in a new volcanic eruption. Although no one lives on the island this volcano is located on, modeling suggests that if this volcano were to erupt, it could scatter ash across the cities of Adak and Atka. The Takawangha volcano is located in the west central Aleutian island chain, where it is centered 59 miles west of the city of Adak. Like other regional islands, Tanaga Island is almost completely volcanic in origin, with volcanic rocks being traced as far back as 250,000 years ago. Takawangha is not the only volcano on the island of Tanaga, as there is also the more active Tanaga volcano, which last erupted in 1914, and has a series of volcanic cones associated with that complex. All of these volcanoes have vents which trend in an east-northeast direction, which somewhat parallels the trends associated with a plate boundary to the south. There, the Pacific plate is subducting underneath the North American plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards until it on occasion erupts onto the surface, forming a chain of volcanoes. Current evidence suggests that the Takawangha volcano has been intermittently active for approximately 75,000 years. During this time, this volcano has erupted explosively numerous times, depositing ash layers such as seen here and dark-colored basalt lava flows across its summit and flanks. Due to the lack of a summit caldera and any very large volcanic craters, it does not appear that Takawangha has produced highly explosive plenian eruptions like sometimes witnessed at the Okmok volcano. Instead, the thickness of ash layers appears to suggest that its average eruptions are somewhat comparable in explosivity to the 2021 eruption of La Palma in the Canary Islands, rating on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as between a 1 and a 3. According to the US Geological Survey, not a single eruption has been precisely dated on this volcano with a low margin of error since the end of the last ice age. However, current evidence suggests that several eruptions have occurred in the last 1,000 years, of which one most likely occurred around 400 years ago. Two of these post-ice age eruptions produced lengthy lava flows which traveled up to 4 miles away from Takawangha's summit. Something of note is that the Takawangha's western flank area is highly hydrothermally altered, which could, during an eruption collapse, producing a voluminous landslide that could theoretically reach the ocean. The ongoing earthquakes are occurring at the rate of slightly more than a dozen a day at shallow depths, likely representing the movement of magma or magmatic gases. It is unclear if this represents a fresh intrusion of magma, although no ground uplift has been detected as of yet. What is of note is that this is the latest of four unrest episodes to have occurred since 2005, and it has produced both the shallowest and highest magnitude quakes of this bunch. Although the prior three episodes did not result in a definitive volcanic eruption, seismic signals implicated that a small phreatic eruption might have occurred during the 2005 swarm. Most likely, a new eruption will not occur, and if one does, existing evidence suggests that it will be explosive but only have a small to medium size. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you would like to support this channel, consider becoming a patron or YouTube member of this channel.